Are you?
No!
You can't fight anything at all. You get completely packed by 3 Gigamen. Well, I'm gonna fix that unless you have a skill issue. So, I know how to fight most of the enemies, and here's how to fight most of them. Okay, for the Shrako, it has like 4 attacks maybe. So this is the double swipe. Always assume that it's gonna be double swipe when he swipes. Always assume that's a double swipe. That's another one. He has the coral attack, just press F and has the auto fairy frames. But always assume that, since you have free tap dancer now, always assume that's a double swipe so that we can just instantly parry it. And then he also has the kick, which you have to dodge. Back in the day, the kick didn't make a sound, but now it does. The golem is my personal least favorite. Most of the attacks you just parry. That and just like a wind up you roll always. And that one you also roll the sounds. For the ones that make sounds, you roll. And for this, you can parry it or you can be a baby and run away. I'm gonna be a baby and run away. But you can also try and parry all of it. So if it makes a sound, you roll. If it doesn't, try and parry. You can also roll all the attacks. There's no unrollable attacks. You can just roll everything if you want to. The Thresher, I have no trouble fighting it. But it's 3 swipes. But just always be ready to parry. Always be ready to parry, no matter what it is. The claws have 2 swipes. That's just 1 swipe that instant posture breaks. You can actually block that if you have enough posture. And all of these are rollable. Just take some time fighting it. It'll take a bit, but work on parrying it rather than countering. Just like that. I'm skipping the angels. I'm not doing this garbage. Okay, next up is the enforcer. Just work on parrying first, because if you parry a bunch, his posture will raise. And if he faints, just hold block. Just keep parrying, and then counter, and you get 2 hits in. And then you can also, ow, you can also crit if you're heavy weapon, that's 3 posture break. But other than that, you can see I'm a little bit laggy, but other than that, just parry a bunch, and if he faints, just hold block. Okay, hopefully it's working now. I tabbed out for 1 minute. Okay, so Sand Knight, try to roll most of the attacks. Don't roll cancel if you don't have to, okay. Well, that kind of sucks. Okay, the last one is the Alpha Sharker. It's just like same as the regular Sharker. It has, I'm trying to get it to do it. It has a little teleport thing like that, and it's simple. You just roll it. You can't parry it. You just roll the attack. Otherwise, it's just a regular Sharko, and very, very little health in Trial of One. Like, nothing. It's almost like, funny how low health it has. Okay, next up is the Hive Mech or the Rogue Mech. They have the same attack path. It doesn't matter. Also, don't ask why I'm on Rusty. I did not lose at all to anything. So the Hive Mech has a few attack patterns. That's the one you want to watch out for. It does a lot of damage. You really want to just face with it. It has an unblockable, and then just try to get some hits in. But the main thing you have to worry about is that this does a lot of damage if you miss it. Okay. It's kind of spooky. Oh, that took so long. Okay, well, that's how you fight that thing. Okay, next up I have on my list is the Nightmare Thresher, which is really, really similar to the regular Thresher. All the same movesets, it just has 2 new moves, which is that, which even though it has the unblockable sound, you can parry it and roll it, you can do anything. just try to avoid it if you can. I'm really lagging right now. Yo, this is not 220 ping. Okay, it's this. You just gotta back up. That's really it. Besides that, it's just a regular pressure. What? Okay, next up we got the Megalodon. Do not compare this to a regular shark. This is nothing like a regular shark. It has so many moves. It has a similar coral move, and it has this, which is a new move, and it has that, which is a new move. So what you want to assume is, while you're fighting this thing, assume that that attack that just happened, this, that's always what happens. So when he does the circle thing, you can roll it. Also, his kick has a wind-up and does a lot of damage instead of on fire. And... okay, now we got the Brain Sucker. If you can't kill the Brain Sucker, you got a problem. But, you know, it's under the list of monsters, so I'm going to go through it anyway. It has two attacks. Okay, ignore that. It has a swing. Okay, it has a swing and it has a grab at its claw. That's literally it. Okay, that's all my way back from Songseeker after Shrining. I came across a Lionfish, so we're gonna convert now. It has two attacks, and in the overworld, only one. It just swims around in the water, and then just bite. Third bite has like an entire AoE that's like around the Lionfish. Are we back here? You keep like towards the back of the Lionfish, and it's the land. So just be careful. Other than that, it has a laser beam, which I've either slowly gotten worse at dodging over time, or it's become more difficult to counter. So just try to hide behind a wall, and if there is none, run away. Okay, next up is the Red Sharko, or the... oh. Okay, never mind. Guess no more Red Sharko. Okay, let's try that again. This is the Red Sharko, or the Crimson Megalodon, which is the same as the Alpha Sharko, except with its scream, which I will try to get it to do by running away from it. And it rains down fire swords that do damage to you, which is where the first fight is supposed to come from. Okay, the first fight. I gotta be careful not getting this thing. There we go. Yeah, they're much tankier compared to the regular Sharkos. And... Alpha Sharko. And you know, while I'm here, I'll cover the Carbuncles. They're kind of like the Brain Suckers, but they're deceivingly, like, difficult to fight. They only have two attacks. That one, which is a lot of posture damage, and this. Four attacks, but less posture damage. But the thing is, they stun them. So, like, I'll try to end with it. You can't. So yeah, a lot of posture damage. Less posture damage, but it stun locks. And the way you tell the difference is the sound cues. Lower pitch scream is 4 swipes. Higher pitch scream is 1 big swipe.
I made an oopsies.
So like, I was at the Chariot Spire because I just deep drilled out of layer 2 because I was like, well, I don't really want to do the rest of the depths mobs on my Maestro build that I'm making, so I was going to use my PvE build. And then I fell. So I guess I'll make that in a couple days. that's like half of them. I'll cover the other half eventually. This is kind of unfortunate. I might buy back. Do I have a restore? Okay, I do. I might buy back. I don't know. Yeah, this is kind of unfortunate. But, yeah. Big oopsies.